However you act, that's accordingly.
All right. No backseas, motherfucker, because I'm a handful.
You just say no backseas?
We used to have a reputation waiver. We
We are not responsible for any professional damage that would cause to your career for being on this show. That is not our responsibility. You knew what you were getting into when you got here.
Right. Assume at your own risk.
At your own risk, yeah. You know you was coming on talking to two drunk niggas, and you got drunk yourself, so that's on you. Be grown.
Don't tell my mom.
I don't know her. So I have no intention of telling her.
Unsolicited opinions. Ooh, I love those.
Come on, nigga, let's go. I've been waiting.
Welcome to Unsolicited Opinions, Season 4. We're back at it again. I got my man Rux in the building. And as always, we drinking Crown Royal.
You can't even say that.
Supposedly. Right.
Y'all don't really know.
Right. And we got special guests in the building. Special guest.
We say that every time.
But everybody's special.
I want something different.
Okay.
Figure it out.
All right.
We got Tony in the building.
No, that's not good enough. That was a lackluster. That was a lackluster effort he did.
Tony the dance machine.
No, that's not
different.
That's not a good hype up. She's like, she wants something different. Like, give her a hype up coming in. We got Tony, the choreographer, in the building tonight.
Yeah.
And mixologist. All across the city of Atlanta, pouring drinks for y'all niggas. So y'all can go outside and shoot each other up.
Don't put that in there.
So that ain't her fault.
That ain't her fault. She just pouring drinks in the club.
It's okay. We're going to fight when this is over.
But you are a bartender at Hookah Lounge, you are culpable.
Because it wasn't as many shooting to the Hookah Lounge.
Came around. It's like all of a sudden Atlanta got a bunch of Hookah Lounges and we got a bunch of murders.
Right.
I mean, do the correlation.
Right. I don't know what they put in that wacky tobacco.
I don't
tobacco.
Know what they're putting in that shit, but.
That wacky tobacco.
Yeah. Let me ask you a question. When last time you been to a Hookah Lounge? Tony.
Oh, I'm like, I thought there was more like mental.
No, when last time you been to Hookah Lounge?
Okay, I go to Hookah Lounges a lot. I have a problem.
Do you own a bulletproof vest? Is my next question.
No.
Oh, okay. Well, you're a female.
You're not paranoid when you go to the Hookah Lounge?
Honestly, no. But you
so
know
you, I, all right, look. Are you more wary coming here tonight?
Yeah,
or the Hookah Lounge?
I don't know.
That's good. You put on the spot with that question because I was trying to answer for her. I was like, that's a tough question. I go to these two niggas I don't know or Hookah Lounge? I don't know.
The thing is, right, if I really felt like I don't know about this, I just wouldn't have, you know? But I brought someone with me just like, even when I don't think it's necessary, I bring someone with me all the time. But it's not like I speak to you every time I see you adults, you know? And I got to meet you too, so it's not even like I only knew one of y'all. But I like to believe and think that I can read people.
Can I ask you a question? Did you do any reference checks on us? Did you like ask any people that we knew mutually that, like, hey, what's up, dumb niggas?
Like honestly,
are they cool or not? So you didn't do that? You fucking up.
No, but yeah.
Because I would have did that.
I feel like Docs is like the same regulars. It's like a family. So
exactly.
Like if you're
that's
a regular at Docs, I'm okay. You know? Because if you do something, I'm a regular at Docs too. So if you do something to me, like that's going to be y'all ass too. Just like if I do something to you, that's going to be my ass.
Yeah.
Everybody would know.
You're regular and I regular is two different things. But
I was
going to
say, because y'all been here way longer than me. But also, like, I'm like the.
She just called us old.
No.
In a respectful, she calls us old in a respectful way. It was a respectful. She's now right like y'all old niggas. She was like, yeah.
No,
it's
okay.
Cool.
So I've only been in Atlanta for 2 years, so I've probably been a Docs regular for like a year. And it's not like I know people more than anybody else, but people take a liking to me at Docs because they tell me I'm just like a bright like some people think I'm like a breath of fresh air. So I think if like you try to do something
and Docs is a lot.
That people be like,
because there's no fresh air in that bitch, man. It's just nothing but Newport's cool, baby. Newport's cools and chicken wing smell. That's all you're going to get in there, baby. That's all you getting in docs. That's
horrible. But you're right. You're absolutely right.
I mean, you're right though. Like when you walk, when you walk in, you like oxygen. Like, oh shit, Tony, we can breathe now. God. Oh, I was about God. To go get my O2 tank out the car. When Tony walked in, I could breathe now. It's like a breath fresh air.
I can't even take this anymore.
All right, so
no, I wasn't scared.
Good, good for you.
Now, okay, scared, so though. You've only been here in the Atlanta metro area for the last 2 years.
That's it.
2 years in February.
So what's your opinion on the area? Years,
January 18th.
So what do you feel, how you feel about it? Okay, let me start. Let me ask, I'm the interviewer. What brought you to Atlanta?
I came here to...
Tell me some landscaping so we could just really have a trip out.
We had I tried to fucking cut your bushes, would you let me?
Yeah. I mean, I'm going to give you one shot. I mean, if you do a good job, I'll carry you back.
Yeah. I look like I couldn't even fucking use...
No, we had a guest that said he came here because he was like, we had grass.
Yeah, he came
from Detroit.
He said the landscaping.
That's why I said that. But yeah. So what brought you to Atlanta? What brought you to Atlanta?
I had a hero or an idol that I looked up to, and I came here to meet him and work on a choreography for a 2-day trip. But I actually ended up trying to stay forever.
Okay, and so where
hold on.
Let's get where she's from.
Okay, I'm from Rhode Island.
That's some stalker shit. That's where I'm going with it. I came here because this nigga.
He was my idol. And I wanted to dance.
I was coming here to meet with him. Like,
please tell me
it's
Tyler Perry. That's the first person that pops in my mind.
No, it's a dancer.
Yeah, but he actually not a good person. But it was someone that I thought would be a good person to work with. So I came to work with someone for 2 days, and then I tried to stay forever. And it didn't work out, but I went home for 5 months, saved up, and then I moved here, like, officially January 18th of 2 years ago.
That old adage is true. It's like, you really don't want to meet your heroes, because when you do meet them, they end up being assholes.
No one ever fucking told me that, so.
Oh, you never heard that adage? Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Here I go, going to be
so
my
you,
hero.
So you went to meet your hero, and he turned out he was a
and
dick.
And then I blocked my hero. How about that?
Really?
I didn't really block him, but I unfollowed him.
Really?
All right,
we're not gonna say no names. So, did that turn you? But that apparently they didn't turn you off from the city itself, though, because you still came.
You know what? Yeah. So what we did was we worked during the day, and then at night we went out. So
the Atlanta nightlife forget
you.
Yeah. So
that's exactly what it was. Yeah. I got it, and it was COVID. So you know, at home everything was closed, even the gym, like the grocery store was closing at 7.
Not here in Georgia. Not in Kemp's, Georgia.
No, this
everything's
was
open.
Wide open. Okay.
Yeah.
Wide open.
You get COVID at the door. Come on in.
Yeah. So that's what really was getting me, because at home we had to literally, we were walking the bike path every day because we couldn't even work out in the gym. Now I come to Atlanta, I'm going to hookah lounges and bars, and y'all got festivals, day parties.
Right. Listen, hookah lounges, you just sharing tips in the middle of COVID.
The COVID, yes. Okay.
And you know, in Rhode Island,
welcome to Atlanta. But COVID runs rampant all day.
In Rhode Island, they were only letting you do hookah outside, and it was fucking freezing outside. So no one was doing hookah.
Isn't it always freezing outside in Rhode Island? Except for like June and July.
Like,
it's all too much, right?
Summer, you know? No,
y'all got summer. It's July.
Yeah.
July, half of August, and maybe that's it.
I mean, it depends. Some years it gets cold early. Some years it don't get cold till later. But
okay, my geography, y'all. Is Rhode Island north of New Jersey? I'm trying to figure it. Or is it like by Delaware? Rhode Island's up by Massachusetts, right?
Yeah, yes. So Rhode Island is technically 15 minutes from the Massachusetts line, and it's 3 hours from New York.
It's above Jersey.
Like, the square mileage in Rhode Island is, like, very small, right? It's a small state in the union, right?
To be honest.
Or is it Delaware? Delaware or Rhode Island is a small state in the union.
We're the smallest state.
Okay, but I said, do you know your state facts?
Wait a minute. How you going to challenge her if you're just displaying your Georgia education?
If you want to talk about facts, I'm not a fact sheet. Like, I don't know about.
You putting your Georgia high school education on blast.
Hold on.
I'm not going to hold you because.
Hold on. I have a Georgia/New Jersey education. Don't get it twisted.
Yeah, well, I don't. So I can't tell you how many. I can't tell your ass how many square feet, but if you want to know where to get some Spanish food, I got you.
Ask me how many square feet Georgia, nigga. I ain't gonna know. But like, it's a lot. You know how many counties in Georgia? It's like 80-something counties in Georgia.
No, it's 138. 132 or 38, somewhere in there.
This nigga know.
Yeah. So I don't know those
Anyway,
they did that. Okay. They did that for racial
for racial shit, and to give the landowners a say in the government. That's what they, right. that's why
so Georgia, each county.
That's why Georgia has so many counties because
So the southern counties get more representation.
So they can legislate how many niggas they can hang per month.
Hold on.
Back in the day. I mean, they had to chill out on that recently.
You see, chill out on that about recently. The same thing. Are we? What do you?
Girl, do you know where you live? Welcome to the South.
Oh my God. Okay.
So you live you're in gonna be Metro good, Atlanta.
Because if you took your braids out, you could pass.
I could pass for what? Fuck you.
You live in Metro Atlanta.
The braids aren't thing giving you away.
Go to hell.
You get 45 miles south of Fulton County.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You go to Buckhead.
Yeah, my ass.
You go to Buckhead and get you a tight perm. You get you a Fortune 500 job downtown tomorrow, girl. You'd be good.
I'm light brown. Hold on, motherfucker,
because
he's not even on the show right now.
That was an off screen.
And you know what comes after that? I love you, girl, but.
Based off the little information we did have on you, it seems like you teach a dancing class at Vixen Studios. Yeah. I'm trying to figure out how you got.
Oh yeah, let's get to the heart of the matter. Yeah, sorry,
how'd you get hooked up with Vixen Studios? When do you teach your classes? You know,
let's talk about you.
Okay, so now that you're making me think about this stuff, I don't necessarily. What my guess is, because, you know, I couldn't find a studio that wants to fuck with me. So what I'm guessing is that I think I saw somebody that I knew post Vixen Studio. Like, they were dancing at Vixen Studio, and it looked nice. And I'm pretty sure I reached out to them.
Right.
And asked them if they were looking for instructors. And I think we had an interview, and it just went really good. Because I do remember the interview. It was amazing. So we had the interview, and they just kind of asked me about my life and how I ended up in their office asking for a slot, and then, you know, we like connected just like that. So I'm pretty sure I had no idea what Vixen Studio was until somebody posted it.
Okay, so how did you get into the dancing arena? Like, what was, like, that was something that came naturally to you, or is it something you...
Like, did your parents put you in dance, or is this your own passion?
No. Okay, did I say it enough times?
No, yeah. Now you have to answer the question.
Yeah, motherfucker, move on. So I went to school for marine biology.
Wow, what a transition.
And I got my degree. I had to go to school.
So you have a degree in marine biology?
Yeah, and my parents parents are so proud.
Oh, I got so many more questions now. Please, I got a bunch of ocean questions now. I want to talk about whales.
No, this is actually really funny because, you know, my parents would always brag like, yeah, like my oldest is at URI. She studied marine biology. So, you know, fast forward to like 6 years later. I mean, I graduated more than 6 years later, but if you fast forward to around six years later.
Yeah, we know your age now. We can do the math.
Fuck you. But like my parents that used to like brag about me being in marine biology, now their friends be like, oh, you know, how's your marine biologist doing? And they're like,
that bitch dancing her ass off in Atlanta.
She's shaking her ass on Instagram, okay?
you know, she down there. You seen her little Wayne video? That's my duck. Yeah. That's my baby.
Yeah, that girl. No. No, it is a really funny, like, weird.
That is a funny transition for you. Because I know parents. The parents was like, they was bragging on you. Like, where's your girl at? Oh, she's in school for marine biology.
She's at URI. I'm at water.
Fast forward 5 years later. Where your baby at? Well, she's down in Atlanta.
She's either in the studio in the fucking Millennium. She's
doing a podcast with two drunk ass niggas. Like, I don't even know what she's doing down there.
Too drunk. Oh my God, that's right. My daughter, he's going to be like, oh, look at my daughter.
We just hope she's okay.
He's going to be like, Mo, whoever you are.
She said she's coming home. She said she's coming home for Christmas, but we don't know. We don't know if she's coming home or not.
If God is real, she'll make it.
But you know what? She could tell you the difference between a skate and a stingray.
Oh. You got a lot of jokes.
All right, when are your classes?
My classes are Wednesday nights at 8:30. I only teach the first three Wednesdays of every month, meaning the last Wednesday of every month, I do not teach.
Okay, so these classes, are they for the beginners or expert people, or is it for anybody? Or
I say my class is for everybody. That's really the question I get literally every single day of my
and
life.
These are dance classes.
Yeah. So if you've never danced before, you will. There's a place in my class. If you've been dancing for 25 years,
there's a place there's in a your place class.
In my class. Yeah.
Where are let the, me let me ask.
Where
you
are the? Hold on. Where are they?
Where's Vixen Studios?
Yeah.
Vixen Studios is on Stone Mountain Highway in Lilburn, Georgia.
You stay out there?
No, I don't. I live, but it only takes me 20 minutes, especially if I'm speeding. It takes me like 18. So it's only 20 minutes away from like Perimeter.
Especially
Mall.
If I'm speeding. That's the Atlanta thing.
I speed.
Especially
baby.
If I'm speeding.
I get there.
Oh, no, we
and
speeding.
I get there first.
Oh, it's yeah. Atlanta, yeah.
She only been here two
years.
Yeah,
she already know. She already know. Like 285 to speed limit, say 55. You drive 55, you want to. Yeah, it's getting ran over. Yeah, you'll get ran over.
Oh my God.
Drive 55 or 285, see what happened.
So y'all drink straight the whole show?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dang, I don't know flat ass Sprite.
Okay. No, no flat ass
Sprite.
Not
during the
show.
That's pregame.
That's pregame.
Pregame.
We don't want our guests to be too drunk before they come on here.
So you don't want them to be too drunk, so you make them drink straight instead of mixing it with flat ass.
Yeah, because after the show, you don't give a fuck about them. You can get the hell alone.
No, you fucking lying.
Play at your own risk.
Yes. Get the love out of my house.
But
okay. I'm responsible for you to the street. Once you get in my driveway.
Right, well, let me ask you this, though. The people coming to your class, are they doing it as a substitution for, exercise?
Yeah,
or are they coming
really,
for?
Like, are these people that's trying to like get a job dancing?
There's a lot. So my class, I do have people that just say, you know, I don't like going to the gym. I'ma just, they wear their Fitbits and they right. dance and they post at the end of class how many calories they burned. Some people do that. Then there's people who, you know, I went to school first and then I started dancing. So I've only been dancing for 3 years. So there's people who saw that I could not dance 3 years ago and now I can. So now they're like, oh, maybe I can be a dancer like her. So some people do come, and even though they've never danced before, their end goal is to
okay.
potentially be.
So I have one question. This is a very important question. I got one question.
You got more than one.
No, this is one. So if me and Chris come to your class, can we film it? Just one class that me and him doing your dance routine.
And have you see you? You clearly have not been to her
like,
IG page.
So he thinks this is funny.
You clearly have not been to her IG page.
You don't think we could do it?
I don't think you would want to do it.
What do you mean?
I teach a heels class.
A what?
A heels class.
What's that?
Ah!
People that dance in heels.
Oh, nigga.
Yeah, like.
Are you going to wear heels?
No, but. I put some penny loafers on and get with it. Like, dude, do you have any men? Okay, let me ask you, do you have any men in your class?
Men do come to my class. And they do.
I forgot. I forgot. I was about to say I forgot it was Atlanta. I forgot it was Atlanta.
That's your fault.
Midtown represent.
No, but how about this?
Here's size 11 heels.
Here's something you didn't think about. He is fucking cracking up. I'm going to beat you. Wait, but.
Yes, you're so right. You're right, though. This is Atlanta, though.
This
is Atlanta, though. You know, we love it.
Are you listening to
me? We love our gay community here in Atlanta.
But it's not just that. You know, I've had so
much. What do you mean it's not just that? You got straight niggas walking together?
Tell him. You keep
right,
us
done.
On track.
I'm
Tell
done.
Him
I'm
he's
done.
Not
I'm
allowed
done.
To talk right. for 1 minute.
All right, go.
Okay. So I've also had a straight person in my. Well, they weren't in my class. They were just at my class. And I have had them jump in and kind of learn my choreo. But he did it as like a man. So when we did it at the end, it was like a woman dancing with a man. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Like a partner. So, yes. So, yes. But obviously, someone off the street wouldn't be. He was a dancer. So he was able to watch me teach, and he was able to kind of do the reverse so that right. when we did it at the end of class, he was doing the choreography, yeah. but he was doing the male part to like.
Wait a minute.
I don't care about the gender roles of the dance. Can you think me and him can do the routine is what I'm saying. Like, can we do your routine?
I do have routines that are just classic hip hop and we just do it in heels. So those ones probably. But yeah. I know if you came to like a slow and sexy
I'm
class,
not wearing
you
heels.
Sit your ass
first
down.
Of all, I wear size 13. Finding heels is going to be kind of tough for me in the first place. So I'm not doing it in heels.
My dad, I think he just turned 56, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh my
and
God.
He makes jokes all the time. He'll be like, oh my God, I'm going to so totally get a 13 size fucking heels and come to your class. And I'm like, Dad, please.
No, I
but
mean,
he can find them down here.
Yeah,
you go right off be mine. He'll find a size 13.
Over Howell Mill over there. It's a shoe store over there.
I'm fucking crying.
You can get like 13 heels over there in men's. I'm just saying, I know where to get them.
I mean, right. that's the thing. Yeah. But that's the thing now. Like, she's one of the few active dancers that we know. Because people don't go to clubs no more and dance.
Everybody meme mugging on each other.
They sit in their section and like, they nigga, drink.
I'm a shoot you at this party's over.
But nobody's really out there sweating.
Sweating like we used to do.
Nobody's really out there dancing.
You behind? Yeah, you missed an era of Atlanta music and dancing. Like we used to go to clubs and dance in the late 90s. I'm being a whole day. When you say your dad's age, I was like, yeah, I probably got more in common with him.
I will say this. I have had men like drug dealers reach out to me and tell me like, yo, like I want to learn how to move with my girl. Like, cause she be in the club and she be dancing and niggas want to dance with her, but I'm not letting them dance with her. So I need you to teach me how to like move with her so she can like dance with me.
Now watch your videos. You got moves. Yeah. I watch your videos. So, you definitely got moves.
I teach choreography, but I have literally had to teach someone how to two step and how to groove and how to just let a girl dance. Like I had to teach him that.
Oh, Chris, should we do a segue so you could do a video? Be like, you got moves. Check this out. I just gave it to you.
She asked the question.
No, but you can edit that out.
Yeah.
She got moves. Y'all should check this out.
Pop it, stop it, drop it, pop it. If I hit a Lexus guy, I'm a motherfucking rocket. Shit, I ain't got no fucking heart. I can't be loyal to you, whore. You weren't here from the start. Twerk, girl, I wanna see you twerk. I throw a little money to twerk. I don't really think you can twerk. Twerk, if you broke, go to work. Make that big booty twerk. Make that big booty twerk. Can I touch that booty? That booty? That big old booty, shake that booty. Can I lay on them booty? Mike Tyson on the booty, copyright that booty. Dang, skinny petite. Dang, I know my bitch love me. Dang, cause she rub my feet. Dang.
Damn! Yeah, y'all saw that, right? Y'all saw that. Y'all saw that. We told you she had moves.
Now listen, you said you just started dancing 3 years ago, or are you saying you just? So you just started dancing three years ago?
My first dance class was 2019.
So what inspired you?
Wait a minute, I'm just saying. Your first dance class or your first dance class instructor was 3 years
ago? Dance class ever.
So you done went from just started dancing to now instructing.
No, she went from marine biology to decide I'm going to be a dance instructor, which is a big jump.
So how long had you been dancing before you decided to come meet your failed hero?
And what made you just give up on the fish?
I never wanted to do that, but I had to pick something to study. I had to go to school no matter what, and I had to pick something, so I picked marine biology. Because I am interested in the ocean. If I have to read about something for 4 years, it can be the water.
That is one of those things where you ask kids, where are you going to be to grow up? Huh? Yeah. I'll be marine biologist. I'll be a doctor. That was one of those things.
So I didn't want to do anything. I'll be
marine biologist. I want to study whales. I like whales. I like dolphins.
Really?
I mean,
whose fucking friend is this?
Yours now, nigga.
So you basically just moved down here and then became an instructor.
I was an instructor at home. So at home, my class like grew up. Like I had 60 girls in every class. Every Wednesday. And I taught Monday nights. My Wednesday night was my class. It was the first class I ever taught. That's the one that got big. But I ended up, by the time I moved away, I was teaching Monday nights in Massachusetts, Wednesday nights in East Providence. That's a class that always had 50-plus girls, mostly 60s.
Then
I taught Friday nights in Providence, and then I taught Sunday nights in Bristol, which was a 35-minute drive from Providence. Like, I was teaching.
The fact that you are making a living doing this, it lets me believe that you're good at what you do.
I'm not going to say I was making a living. I mean, well, I guess back then, you know, I lived with my parents, so it was paying my bills. But
I mean, you're doing this now here in Atlanta, though, right?
Yeah, but I bartend. I sling the fuck out drinks to pay these bills.
Because one thing that don't stop, that's bills. They don't stop. But they don't stop.
And she's doing choreography.
But you still do. You still dance, right?
But she not doing the dances that pay like the rest of the Atlanta folk. Them dances. Yeah. She ain't at the city.
I got one question. Can you geek it up?
She don't know what that is.
Can I what?
She just been here 2 years. She don't know what the fuck that is.
I was like, can you eek it up?
I don't know what the fuck that is.
Yeah.
We'll have to show you a video.
We gotta show.
Watch this right here.
Yeet.
You ready?
Yeah.
Can you get ready? Ladies and gentlemen, the one who started it all.
Woo!
At the prisons.
Hey!
This will be going. We got to the right, to the right, to the right. To the right.
We gonna eek it up for you one time, ATL style, shouty. There's some hoes in this house.
Oh, I know that song. Hoes. Certified freak, yeah.
All right, so this is dancing is your passion.
Yes.
Slinging drinks pay the bills.
Yeah, but slinging drinks is my passion too. So.
Really?
Yeah. I didn't know. Too. I didn't know it was for real.
I'm slinging them tonight.
I'm dead. No, I didn't know that was another passion that I had until I really got into real bartending here, because at home I was like dive bar bartending, and there's nothing, it's not like my dream was always to make a good Henny and Coke, you know, but once I moved here and
that's
I learned
aspiration.
Yo,
what's the real vibe just do now?
She make a drink for niggas. What you want? Henny and Coke. I got that. I can make them all day long, baby. That's how you want Henny and Coke. You don't want that.
You're the oldest, right? You studied marine biology. What's she doing now?
You weren't lying with that. You were lying with that, honey.
She's Hennessy, and she teaches girls how to dance. Oh my God, no! But when I moved here, I learned how to really bartend. Like I learned how to make my, you know, ingredients from scratch. I learned how to mix. I learned how to actually mix drinks when someone doesn't have a recipe, but they tell you what they like. I learned enough about bartending how to mix together. No, wretched ass. No, nobody fucking. Oh, he doesn't get it.
No, I get it, man. I'm fucking with you. Dad, I told you I'm over here for the side. I'm over here for the comedy.
Yeah.
I'm just no. No.
First of all,
let's get this out of here. I respect all my servers and bartenders in the industry.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
Those are my peoples. Like, those are me and those are the people that support this show. The servers, the bartenders, the late night folks that are out there.
That
slang.
Is our audience.
Yeah. That is our audience. That's our audience, because they know us.
Down to earth.
Yeah, exactly. And
we don't give a fuck about no pay time off. We give a fuck about
And those people are not judgmental. Those people, like, they take you how you come,
yeah,
because they deal with them people on a daily basis, and they take you how you come, and those are our peoples, like the bartenders, the serving staff, the servers all over the world, y'all unsolicited peoples.
Right, so quick question for you.
Yeah.
Top three bartender pet peeves.
Yo, you go.
Oh, man, y'all gonna have to edit this and just...
No, we not.
I'm about to give you 29 by accident.
No, give us your top three.
Okay. Top three pet peeves
of a bartender:
sitting at the bar and not ordering anything.
That's a good one.
Can you please stand up? You know that song by Ludacris?
Yeah.
Stand up,
nigga. You holding the spot if somebody got some money.
That's what I'm saying. Bro, when you know what it's like to go up to somebody and say, "Hey, like, how you doing today?" Like,
let me get the water.
I'm Tony, what are you drinking today? Oh, I'm cool.
No, you're not cool.
You're not cool.
You're not cool, bro. You sitting there holding a seat of somebody who actually got some money in their bank account. So no, you're not cool. Yeah.
That guy circling the bar.
Yeah.
Looking for somewhere to sit.
Yeah. That nigga got money. You sitting here with your broke ass trying to order water. Like,
because you can just walk up to the bar. You can ask for water. I'll give you water. But if you're sitting in my seat, I can't.
No, there's water in the bathroom. You can cup.
Like, that's nasty.
That nigga in the bathroom gonna be good. He be like, "Hey, you want some water? I got mints.
Got some water." He probably got bottled water.
He got bottled water in there.
I got
bottled water. I got Fiji.
The bathroom attendant. Got some condoms, Fiji, Altoids. What you want?
What you want, nigga? Black and mild. Oh, you got Black and Miles? Oh, yeah, let me get one there.
I can't.
Oh, you got Lucy's too? Let me get a Newport too. One way out. I think I'm gonna fuck this bitch. Let me get a condom too.
Oh my god.
Oh, you don't know about the bathroom and tennis in Atlanta?
All right, so what's number two?
Number two is not tipping. And it's not only about making money, but you're also taking up my time as money. So when I do stuff for you and you get a tab for you to just not tip.
I'm on the service industry side on this one. Please tip your server. And what we've learned over the course of our long career hanging out is when you tip good, you get good service. And we learned like when I first go to a spot and I get a drink, I'm gonna tip heavy on the first one.
I'm telling you, and so every that time, we know what's up.
And then next time I make eyes with them, like, I got you.
Because now when the bar is crowded, they see you. Oh, that motherfucker tipped good. 25
yeah,
minutes
I'm gonna give him his drink.
Not at all.
We don't even
order drinks now.
Well, that's a whole nother subject. But any regular bar, yeah,
we don't even order drinks.
No.
Right. And that's the thing, like tipping, it matters. No, especially tip if good. You're at a bar that's busy.
Especially,
you do not have to wait. We are coming to you.
I'm gonna go where the money at. Like okay, that dude period. Just gave me that $10 tip.
Period.
I'm gonna try to get another like $30-$40 this nigga for a nice over.
All right, number three.
And his drink gonna be weak as shit, but I'm gonna give him anyway.
Honestly, like the things I'd be ranting like on my story is always about like tipping and sitting at the bar and not ordering. But if I were to say a third one, I think I would say for a pet peeve. I think I would say, damn, this is a hard one.
Probably for you. I'm a guess for you. For you flirting with the bartender.
Honestly, not really. Especially if you pay. Because, you know, I don't mind.
Oh.
Oh, sorry.
So, well, we got a live hoe in here tonight.
Oh, my God. That's fine. I can't. How
if
about,
you pay, you can talk to her.
How about how automatic? I was like, no, that's okay.
What can I solicit it?
Right. It's a money, right?
Okay. No, now you have to let me explain myself because you just said a live hoe in here.
I'm fucking with you, Tony. No. I'm just messing with you. But you set yourself up for that joke.
Please,
set yourself up for that joke. I had to get it off.
You know, in Atlanta sometimes, well, not in Atlanta, in general, but before Atlanta, I didn't work in a real bar. But you know, when people are flirting with you and you just, because you know, you can ignore.
I mean, yeah, it gets annoying though, right? It gets annoying as a bartender, right? It doesn't get
honestly,
annoying.
If you find it, doesn't get annoying.
See, it's always preferences.
I'm not gonna lie.
And back to what I just said.
We got a live one.
Especially if I'm working at a bar where I can drink. I've been drinking too. So if you want to flirt and you're going to keep tipping, like, go ahead because I can.
So the flirt, I've seen dudes that be heavy on the flirt and be like, man, dude, just stop.
Okay, yeah. There's a line. Yeah. So if you want to tell
like,
me,
she's about to call the police on you, bro.
Okay, yeah. So there's a line. So that kind of shit's not okay. But if you want to just tell me how beautiful I am every time I give you a drink, that's okay. But if you want to start talking about what you want to do to me every time I give you a drink, now I'm finna give you like, a tab. And you
crown,
finna go.
Let me get that crown and I'm gonna put it in your butt.
Oh! Both
things,
that's funny.
Let me get that crap. I'm putting right. your butt later.
No, yeah, so that shit, I'll be like, no.
You not feeling that? You don't feel that?
This is what I think the are
pet you done?
Is.
What can I solicit opinions?
So I think the pet peeve is the hey. Hey.
Oh yeah,
Miss Lady. Miss Lady.
I'm telling you, I'm so glad you. I couldn't think under the pressure. I'm like, damn, if I had to pick one, that's what. Excuse me, miss.
Shawty.
Yeah. Who? I'm tall. Fuck is you talking about? Like,
hey, little mama.
No.
Hey,
no, mama. I ain't got no kids. How about that? No, but that's really annoying because.
Or in your. A red. Come here,
no,
for a red.
That is very. Let me how you red.
Hey, braids. Let me get, hey, come on here, braids.
Ah.
Let me get a hand and coat. And my wife has some wings. Let me get Tempe's lemon pepper.
Lemon pepper. Y'all love fucking lemon pepper.
I mean, come on, it's Atlanta.
Y'all love hot. Oh,
y'all, you ain't
really
yet.
No, you ain't lemon pepper.
But you hit it head on. Yeah. I.
Hey,
you know what?
Hey.
Sometimes I hate it so much that I'll say, Tony, did you mean to say Tony?
No.
How can I help you?
No, he said Shawty. especially when it's busy. That's
like,
when I see my service get so frustrated because we feel our service out at our bar, at our hole in the wall. We could feel our service out. We know what how they feeling, and we know when to ask them for something or when not to ask them for something. So we kind of, I know what you're saying.
I
mean, yeah.
I disagree with you to some extent.
I was going to say, because it's okay to ask for something, but just make it quick, like, hey, Tony, when you get a chance, can I get a water?
That's what I do.
If I'm busy, don't say Tony.
No.
Tony.
That's my move. That's my move with my bartender. I was like, hey, whenever you get a chance, make me one.
Just get it out. Just say
Professor
what you need.
X-Men, but
Chris is an asshole. No, you are an asshole. Where my drink? Bitch, I asked for this drink like 10 minutes ago. Why I ain't getting this?
Don't put that out there.
He's a little demanding. He's a little demanding.
I've learned the skill of Professor X-ing my bartenders now. I don't even speak. I sit at the bar and I just stare at them. And they know, because I ain't got to tell them what I want to drink. They already know what I want.
I
just give them the stare.
I'm a co-sign on that. He's right.
I don't be like, hey.
But sometimes it depends on the vibe of the bar and what's going on at the bar at the time. Sometimes me and him can just walk in and we just get that look like, and this is our favorite move. Just throw the one up.
You know, sometimes or it comes off. Like
two with both of us.
Sometimes when we do that, it might come off a little like, okay, nigga, I'm coming. But that's also sometimes it's just because we're in the moment. But if I look at you and I say, okay, I do something like that, it means I see you. If you acknowledge me, let me know you see me. I won't bother you no more. It doesn't always come off as, okay, I'll be right there. Sometimes it's like, okay, nigga, but nonetheless, I saw you. Because
I got bartenders, I'll do the one, and then, like, if I don't got a drink, like, 20 minutes later, I'm going to do the one again.
Yeah.
And I'll be like, hey.
The stare works, though.
The one, you go one, and then 20 minutes later goes, nigga, look, I'm
dead.
Yeah, yeah, you throw the hand, I'm like, what?
We have such good rapport now. Yeah. You just walk in and... they'll look at you. Look at him.
Yeah, you get the eye contact. Yeah,
how many?
Is he the one or two with us? Me and him. Yeah. Because if we together, it's two. If we solo,
honestly,
one.
Like, sign language is important too. Like this, if you want another one, you gotta go like this, like another round. You know.
Okay.
So
what's the sign language for drunk?
Drunk?
Yeah. What's sign language? Hold on. I'm gonna see.
Check. I'm going home. Can I get my check?
Well, all right, what's the sign language for 86? What's the sign language for 86?
Like, you don't have something?
Like, no, 86. Wait, well, motherfucker got to go. Like, you got 86 something. Like,
when you don't ask for your check and I give
no,
you
no,
check?
When you're talking to your other staff, like, this guy got
to
go.
I'll point to them and I'll go, no more.
Oh, just to cut off?
Yep, no more.
But that's what I do when I'm ready to get out for the night. When I'm ready to leave.
You're 86 in yourself.
My bartender's one, like, I got to go. I'm like, cut me off. Yeah. I got to get out
of
here.
A lot of times, you shouldn't have to tell your bartender. Your bartender be like, that nigga done.
No, my bartenders don't know that. They don't know our limits. They don't know our limits. Are you biracial, right?
I am Cape Verdean. So I'm, it's like,
see,
you know what Cape Verdean is?
The nuances. Like, they're going to do everything they can to keep away from the Caucasian side.
Cape Verdean is it's an island off the coast.
I know
of Africa.
I'm familiar with Cape Verde.
It's Cabo Verde. You talk about Cape Verde. What the fuck is that?
She said, hold on, you said it, and then all of a sudden it was Cape Verde, and all of a sudden it's
Cape Verdean is the people, but it's the island is
it's
Cabo Verde.
Mm-hmm.
I guess.
Okay, so
Georgia education.
It's off the east or west coast of Africa.
We talked about questions like this. I don't fucking know.
I'm only asking not to trying to be trying to spy.
I think
it's off the west coast of Africa.
I think it's off the east.
I honestly don't know.
All right,
we don't know. We're gonna throw a map on the screen. Yeah.
So your family, how many generations are you removed from that?
Huh?
Is your dad from there?
No,
your mom?
No. So my dad's from Chicago, so we just call him black.
He a nigga.
That nigga from Chirac.
And you know what's funny? When I was a kid, and he's from Chirac, he was in the gangs. That's why we're here. He moved here with my mom because he was in a lot of trouble over there. But
the real stories. Yeah.
Snitching.
Yeah.
Stop snitching.
I mean, he's 56 now, so catch him if you fucking can. But anyway.
Well, you done told him where he is.
He in Atlanta. I'm dead. Hey, FBI. Hey, hold on. I'm finna go on the live website. Niggas got warned on him. I don't give a damn.
How much the reward? How much reward?
Oh, shit. This nigga worth a million. We finna turn him in.
Where you at, girl?
No, he gonna find you first. You on the show talking that shit, he gonna find you first.
I don't care. My homeboy gives me a 30 clip.
He just gives me. All you need is
I got an extendo now. You tell him run up on him if you want to.
Yeah, I did give him that for Christmas. Yeah.
All right, Cape Verde, or Cabo Verde, officially the Republic of Cabo Verde, is an archipelago, an island country in the central Atlantic Ocean. So it's off the Atlantic Ocean, so that means it's going to be off the
West Coast.
It's going to be off the West Coast of Africa.
West side?
That looks pretty, though. Look at that. That
it is. It's beautiful. Yeah.
So, have you been there?
No.
It's for your
bucket list.
So is your mom and dad from there, or just
no? So my dad is from Chicago. He's just black.
So where's your mom from?
My mom's parents were born in Cape Verde. But my mom was born in Providence.
So your parents are just Americans.
Yeah, they're American as fuck. And you know what? My mom is one of
10. But your culture is from the African.
So my family is really big. So a lot of us speak it and we cook the food. Like, we actually know a lot about the culture. But my mom is one of 10, mm-hmm. and she's number 9.
So she didn't get much of the culture. Yeah,
the older ones, they're the ones that speak it. Like, you know? So,
Your mom was like, she's Americanized. She's Americanized.
And we're American as fuck.
And your dad's family probably from Mississippi or Alabama. Yeah. Because of the migration to Chicago,
black joke? I don't know.
It's not a joke. It's like all of our families left the South when they could and moved to the North.
Yeah,
because they was tired of getting whooped.
What's your favorite dish from there, though?
Oh, Kachupa.
Oh, what's that?
And conch. They're both soups, but they're fucking.
I'd like a good soup now.
It probably exists and I probably haven't looked, but anybody who could learn how to make kachupa and sell it in Atlanta,
How to make any traditional dishes? Did you learn anything from Mama? Do you learn anything from Mama about traditional dishes?
It's not traditional, but it was her thing. She would always make macaroni salad. And I know you guys have macaroni salad everywhere and I don't care.
Macaroni salad and macaroni cheese are two different things.
No, macaroni salad.
I love a good macaroni salad.
Yeah, but I just feel like the way y'all make macaroni salad and potato salad countries as hell out here. Like,
Wait a minute. Don't be disrespectful toward the potato salad.
I'm not saying it's not good.
I was about to check her ass.
I'm not saying it's not good. Hold up.
Nigga, don't be blaspheming potato salad in here. Because, like, they get your ass whooped. Niggas for real, but that potato salad. Potato salad and deviled eggs. Right. Hold up. Now.
We fried deviled eggs.
Y'all got fried deviled eggs at the Lazy Dog?
Yeah.
Ooh, we gotta go.
Y'all hungry?
Next food review.
Nigga, I would eat anything that's fried. Nigga, you hear me?
Next food review.
Anything some hot grease, and I'm about that.
We doing that for the next food review.
Fried double eggs?
And we bring them here and eat them on camera.
Oh, my God. We're going to bring Mo on, too. Like, Mo, we got the proprietor of the Lazy Dog in North Point.
Proprietor?
We can exaggerate.
Like, Mo, come on, nigga.
Who go check us?
Yeah. Don't worry. Your superiors won't see this video. Yeah, come on.
Like, Mo.
If they do, you get famous, nigga. Fuck them. So at the end of every show, we do a survey and ask our guests how they, from 1 to 10, how do they feel about their experience on the show? So how do you feel about your experience on the Unsolicited Podcast? From 1 to 5, 5 being the highest, give us a number.
I'll give you your ass a 6.
No, get out of here. Don't gas us up now. You're gassing us up.
Okay, let me ask some questions.
All right. Nobody's never asked us any questions.
That's never happened.
Ask us some questions. What you want to know?
Have you seen me, like, stop smiling one time since I walked in the door?
No, I haven't.
No, but we thought that was because of the laughing gas.
I just thought you did a lot of cocaine.
Cocaine.
I just think you just geeked up when you walked in the door.
I'm Tony. You can find me on Instagram at Lady with two Y's, LADYY underscore PAPA. I also have an Instagram for my heels class by itself. It's heels, HEELS, the letter N, hype, HYPE. I teach Wednesday nights at 8:30 at Vixen Studios. Vixen's has a Z at the end. Studios has an S at the end. It is on Stone Mountain Highway in Lyburn, Georgia, 4814 Stone Mountain Highway, Lyburn, Georgia. Come dance with me. I don't care if you've never danced
y'all
before.
Y'all go dance with Tony,
come
man.
Come dance with me. Let me show
if
you
if all y'all ladies have any interest in dancing, she's a professional. Y'all go dance with her. She's out in Lyburn, Georgia. It don't cost you. What's the cost for this?
Classes are $15.
$15. Especially all y'all ladies ain't got no rhythm. Y'all go out there and dance with Tony.
I did not sign off on that part.
Even if you do got rhythm, go dance with her.
That's three Starbucks coffees.
That's three Starbucks coffee, and you can get a good workout in and a good dance lesson. It's a win-win. It's a win-win for you. Go dance with Tony. She's got the moves. Y'all going to see it, and it's a podcast. There's going to be some clips of her dancing.
All right.
Go check out Tony. Thank you for tuning in to Unsolicited Opinion. We love y'all. Poochie, Rux, Tony, we out of here. And we got Mo in the corner with his drunk ass.
'Hey, this is Rick Joyner of The Rick Joyner Experience, and you're listening to Unsolicited Opinions.